remember the kind of September when life was slow and oh so mellow. Try to remember the kind of September when grass was green and grain was yellow. Try to remember the kind.
That's my new theme song.
All of our new things.
That's why I have my papers right here. Try to remember. Oh, welcome to Sing for Your Supper. It's good to see you all. Hope you all had a nice March, and here we are in beautiful April.
I know. So nice. I'm happy that April. Maybe the weather will even out a little bit.
Well, it's been sunny today, but
wait, five
this
minutes.
Morning anyway.
Yeah,
it's exactly.
We'll take it.
Yeah, I hope you had a good month, and this is going to be a great month because we have some holidays we're celebrating.
That's right. Yeah. Big holidays, especially for those of us in that business.
That's right. And you have a show that just closed.
Yes.
And it was very successful.
Very successful run of the Sparkle Tones.
Sold out, wasn't it?
Mostly sold out.
That's fantastic. Yeah. Well, congratulations
on
that.
Thank you for that little shout out.
Absolutely. And what are we doing today?
Let's try to remember. You know, we mentioned when grain was yellow, we are featuring grains today.
Wonderful. And what's the show that we're talking about?
Oh,
if you don't know, I can't believe you don't know that song.
Fabulous Jerry Orbach singing Try to Remember from the Fantasticks.
And another one of the shows that was not on Broadway.
Never on Broadway. Is the longest running musical in New York ever with 17,162 performances.
Wow, that's more than a year, isn't it?
I did five shows a day. No. We've got lots of fun info. It was in Branson. They cut it down to an hour. And there was a buffet.
Yes, exactly. And a little patriotic number at the very end.
Yes.
What a beautiful show, though. And it can be done anywhere. I mean, community theater, professional theater.
Yes.
High school. I mean, it's just a very...
It is touching and beautiful. Yes. And it speaks to families. And
it does.
If you've never seen it, I don't know, where you know, people do it all the time. Get yourself to a production of the Fantasticks. Yeah. You know, there's a little bit of controversy now because they refer to, there's an abduction in the show, which is referred to as a rape, which goes back to, it was based on an Edmond Rostand play.
Oh, Edmond.
Who wrote one of my favorites, Cyrano de Bergerac, where they refer to an abduction or kidnapping as a rape. And so it's taken a little heat from that. It could easily be changed, I think, but... Other than that language, the show is wonderful.
Yeah, and if nothing else, get the soundtrack because it's just beautiful. It's scored for four instruments, but it sounds like a full orchestra.
Very
it's
simple.
So beautiful. Yeah, and the singing on the soundtrack is amazing.
And in the revival that they did in, hold please.
Are we cooking dinner? Or we just...
I don't know. We're just talking about the show. They revived it in 2010, and one of the original cast members, and you can get, I think that recording is Santino Fontana, who just won the Tony 2 years ago for playing Tootsie. So, great voice. Not Tootsie.
Tootsie. Yes.
I suddenly got that and try to remember, Barb.
Now you can play Girl and Fantastic.
That's right.
Actually, anyway, you have to play one of the fathers.
Yeah, listen to that score sometime. Okay.
All right.
Let's talk about what we're making.
Well, I'm going to be back here for most of the day because I'm making risotto. And if you have never made risotto, it's not something you want to make by yourself. You want to have a friend to come help you because you can say, oh, you've always wanted to cook with me. Here's your chance. Come stir the risotto.
Come stir the risotto.
Because it's basically this. So... I'll see you all in just a few minutes. I'm going to start mine, and then you can tell what you're going to do, because it does take a little bit of time.
Okay, then you jump right in.
So, risotto is made with arboreal rice, and you need to have this kind of rice specifically for the risotto. And what we're going to do is we're going to toast the rice after I brown, or I'm going to put my garlic and my shallots into the butter back here, and we're just going to let that get translucent, and then we're going to toast the rice. Mm-hmm. Then we're going to add some wine to it, and then we're going to just start adding chicken stock, and that'll be me back there for the next 45 days, putting chicken stock in and stirring. And when the chicken stock is all absorbed into the rice, then we'll add some flavorings to it, and it'll be ready to serve. This is a great main course. You can also put some protein with it, like so roast some shrimp and put on it. And once you get through the stirring, it's a pretty simple little meal.
Right. And because you stir it so long and this kind of rice absorbs mm-hmm. so much, it becomes mm-hmm. creamy.
Oh, it's really lovely. Yeah.
It's got a little al dente to it. It's yeah. really good.
Yeah, I've had people say, are you going to put cream in it? We're not putting cream in this time, but you can put cream. We're just using the chicken stock and the butter. And that's going to, and the wine, and that's going to be our liquids for this. So I'm gonna get started by putting my shallot. I've got one shallot and two cloves of garlic that I chopped up. We're gonna put that in the butter back here, and I'm gonna get that translucent, and then I'll interrupt Barb with the next item.
Okay.
All right, here
okay.
I go.
And it goes, it's gonna sizzle, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
And here, you need a little.
I do need a little.
You need a little something?
This is my
little
friend for the next half hour.
That's right.
All right. Now, what are you making?
I am making two kinds of quinoa salad.
Two? I didn't know there were two kinds of quinoa salad.
There are.
I didn't know there was one kind of quinoa
lots
salad.
Lots of quinoa salads. And one thing I did, I wanted to point out, was I did a combo of just traditional quinoa, which is kind of that cream color. Put a little on my hand here. Very little. It's the whites. One, and then I mixed it up with the red, and I think it just makes it really pretty. They kind of taste the same. The red might be a little earthier, but you cook them the same way, you cook them at the same time. There you go.
Is there any difference in the nutritional value?
I don't think so. Let's look at the nutritional value of quinoa. There's not a whole lot to it. It's got fiber, of course.
Which is great. He's full.
Got a little bit of iron, a little bit of calcium. But it's just a great base. It's got a nutty, kind of earthy flavor. So nice. I really like it. So my first one I'm going to make is a roasted. It's a little heavier, a little more hearty. Almost for the fall, but coming out of spring, it's still okay.
While you're getting that, I'm going to show you when to put the rice in. The onions and the garlic have turned translucent. So I'm just gonna dump the rice in and we're gonna toast that for about 5 minutes. Bye. See you later.
Woo! Thanks for that update. So this is my first batch of quinoa, and I roasted some sweet potatoes earlier in the oven at about 400 to 415. Make sure when you chop up your sweet potatoes, they're all about the same size, so they roast evenly. Cooked them for 10 minutes, gave them a little stir, get like another 6-7 minutes, and there you go. That's going in.
I love roasted vegetables.
Oh.
We do it every once in a while, but it just brings out the flavor of the vegetable. So great.
And it's so easy.
It's so easy. It's easier than any other way to cook vegetables.
It is.
And you're just going to reward yourself by doing it.
Broccoli, cauliflower, asparagus, green beans, sweet potatoes, anything. A little olive oil, a little salt and pepper, and oh my gosh, just
and
yummy.
And it's even better when you get it from the farm stand or the farmer's market.
Yes.
It's like candy. It's actually like candy.
It's like candy.
Sorry, I have to be stirring.
Stir. I've got about a cup of, I did a combo just for the color of yellow, red, and orange bell peppers. Ooh. And that's going. Cup of chopped broccoli.
Yum.
Yeah. And because I love them and it's a little more protein, I'm putting in a cup of garbanzo beans.
Wow.
Yeah.
You've done what you always do. She fills it to the brim.
I'm going to get a bigger bowl. Hey, talk about your risotto while I get a bigger bowl.
So we see risotto's covered in the butter and the shallots. Thank you. Shallots.
Try to remember.
I know.
What's the ingredients?
It's hard. Who are you?
Hello.
How are you doing
nice
here?
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, so they're all in here, and we're just going to brown these.
I love, anytime I cook rice, we're kind of getting off the tracks here, but we're just giving you some tips. When I cook rice now, you want to rinse it really, really well until the water runs clear.
Yep.
Then I like to always toast my rice in a little bit of butter.
Mm-hmm.
Then I cook it according to the directions, either with water or some kind of broth. Makes such a difference rinsing all the rice clean. It makes it not so clumpy and glutinous.
I'm gonna use some white wine for my broth today. One cup of white
wine. Let me get a glass.
I have to use it all, sorry.
Okay, so all of that is my quinoa salad. I'm gonna put in my big bowl And now I'm going to show you how to make an easy, nice vinaigrette to go with this.
It doesn't look like as much salad as you had earlier.
I know. Everything, perspective is everything.
That's right.
Okay, so what I have here is a half a cup of olive oil. And it, this one, because I like it because of the sweet potatoes, we add a little bit of sweetener. You could do maple syrup or you could do agave. I'm doing agave because it was handy. Okay. 2 tablespoons of a sweetener.
Very healthy.
It's a really healthy salad, but it is delicious. There's that. Now we're going to do some fresh lemon juice. Doing half a lemon. My handy dandy little juicer, which makes it a breeze. There we go. And this lime was small, but I'm calling this a half a lime because it was just a tiny little thing. So I'm gonna do both. I'm not even getting much liquid out of there.
We're not gonna zest this lemon, are we?
We are not.
Because we always
we would
do that
have done it first.
There you go. Thank
we
you.
We would have done it first. There's my lime juice. Okay. Lime juice. A little. You know what I'm going to say, Brenna? Salt and pepper. Here it comes. A little salt. A little pepper. That's it.
Yeah.
That's it. Let me grab a whisk.
All right, back to the risotto. We had 1 cup of wine we added to that, and see how the risotto or the arborio rice has really picked up that. So it's all incorporated.
Mm. Oh, I can smell that wine.
So now what we do is we add a cup of chicken stock until it's, we put a cup of chicken stock in and it absorbs, and then we put another cup of chicken stock in. So we get 4 to 5 cups of chicken stock in here.
How long do you stir between each cup? Approximately.
Till one gets incorporated. So I'd say 4 or 5 minutes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Don't think you can speed this process along by turning the stove up to high.
Don't do it.
It will just make it will be a mess. So don't do it. So you have to do it slow and just be patient. I'm the slow part, the patient part, not so much.
Okay, here is my easy vinaigrette.
And the chicken stock has to be hot, so I've got it on the stove here. Because you don't want to cult, you don't want to put the cold stock
in. I want Kevin to taste this.
Mmm.
Isn't that nice?
I like the sweetness in
that. The little sweetness is going to really bring out those sweet potatoes. So I'm just going to pour this over. Easy peasy. And one thing you can add before you serve with this one, if you like, is some fresh avocado. Add it when you're going to serve it so your avocado doesn't get brown and mushy. Isn't that beautiful?
What a beautiful salad.
I know. Put that. Now you could add a protein to this. You could put shrimp on top. It does have protein in it, but you could add some chicken.
Yeah.
Or put,
a meal there.
Serve it. Put chicken on top and make this your bed or your base.
That says spring.
That says spring. There we go. I just think it's a beautiful, delicious salad. Ta-da! Easy! And quinoa cooks in about 20 minutes. You bring your water to a boil. You simmer for 15 minutes. Quinoa's finished.
And do you have to stand and stir it for 20
you
minutes?
You do not.
Oh.
It is a very self-sufficient little grain.
Let's switch.
You put a lid on it and it's done.
Okay, I just remembered another try to remember joke that's very funny.
Oh, okay.
This is from the Golden Girls. Oh. They were on, Dorothy and Sophia were on a talent show in a nursing home. And one of the ladies sang Try to Remember, and Dorothy says, it was so bad. She sang Try to Remember, and she couldn't.
She couldn't. Here's to Betty White. Yeah, we love her.
And we love Betty White. We love all the Golden Girls.
Oh, we do. We do. It brought us so much joy. Yeah. Okay, guess what? It's time for my second quinoa salad. This one is an homage to Greece. So it's a take on a Greek salad. Again, same base. I've got, and this is about a cup of the cooked quinoa. So it absorbs, it's a 2-to-1 ratio, 1 cup of quinoa to 2 cups. And I cooked it in vegetable broth. I think it just gives it a little more flavor. You could certainly do it in water or chicken broth, whatever you like. So we're gonna add that.
Which one of the quinoas is this one?
Well, this is a combination of
both. Oh, I'm sorry, I wasn't listening.
That's okay.
I was stirring.
Try to remember what I said. You were stirring.
Stirring. I forgot. I've got to go back and stir. Excuse me.
You know, well, I'm going to take a quick break and we're going to talk about our show.
All right.
The Fantasticks.
Yes.
Was written by Harvey Schmidt, Tom Jones. Harvey did the music. Tom did the lyrics. Based loosely on the Romancers by Edmond Rostand. Off Broadway, it ran for, do you want to guess how many years?
Well, you told me I had performances, so
yeah.
I don't really have time to do the math because I'm kind of busy back here. So why
don't
you
just stirring.
Just? It's risotto.
42 years.
42 years?
42 years.
Oh my gosh.
And
now, I guess the original cast still wasn't doing it.
I don't think so. Although, interestingly, Tom Jones, was that him? Hold on. Tom Jones was in the original show as the old actor, if you know the show. He had to use a pseudonym, but he performed in the show for a while. Jerry Orbach, many of us probably know him. Mm-hmm. Great Broadway performer. He was on one of those crime shows. Law and Order, I think.
Yeah,
just a great actor. He was the original El Gallo, the cat, which is the narrator. They got the idea to use a narrator from our town.
Oh, he thought that
was such a great idea.
This is kind of the musical Our Town. I mean, it's not the same story, but it's the no set.
Very
costumes,
little set,
lights,
kind of like a Paget wagon.
Yeah, and the lights kind of tell the story. Yeah,
very simple. You're right. They did. They pulled from a lot of different shows to get this together, and the narrator came from Our Town. So, but 42 years. And I found this fascinating. As of 2010, the original investors of the show had earned back 240 times their initial investment.
Wow.
Pretty good, because you can imagine back then, they all probably kicked in $500. So they probably have a house with the,
Do you think that will happen with the Sparkle Tones?
Well, it might. I'd love that. Hey, we need some investors.
Yeah.
Okay, back to my salad.
All right.
This is a Greek quinoa salad. And one of the things it features is an English cucumber. Now, what does it say? Because it speaks with an accent? No, that's not why it's an English cucumber.
Oh, okay. I'm with you now.
Okay.
I got distracted stirring right here.
So, there's kind of three types of cucumbers. There's one that's called a peeler, which is your just traditional one you'll see at the grocery store. Pickle ones that you use to make pickles. And then the English. Now, there's way many more varieties than that, but those are the three main ones. This is recognizable because it's a little thinner, it's usually a little longer, and it comes wrapped in plastic. Why? Why, you say?
Why?
Because the skin is thinner, and they don't put wax on this before they sell it. The cucumbers in the produce department that you pick up have wax over the skin, and it's thicker. And the taste is a little more bitter.
Yeah.
These thinner skin, less small seeds, so sometimes this is called a burpless cucumber, and you don't really have to deseed it, and it's got almost a sweet taste to it. So I really like the English. They are a little bit more expensive, but if you see them on sale or you want to try it, there is your tutorial on English cucumbers. So I am going to
You've done my fair lady today. Why can't the English
be more like the peelers?
Exactly where I was going with that.
Oh, okay. We're going to start here. And I am going to peel this. Where's my peeler? Talk.
All right. I'll show you our consistency now of the rice. See, it's fluffing up just a tad. Put 3 cups of the chicken stock in at this point. So it's not ready for any more because you see it's
still got absorbed.
We gotta wait for it.
We could have done Hamilton.
All these shows. Put your comments down below of all the shows that we've
done. What are some shows you'd like to see?
Yeah.
And tie in some food to it. We can't do all the work.
We'll cook it if you'll tell us what to do.
Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna give this, but you can see this is a thin And honestly, you probably could just wash this and use it if you wanted to keep the skin on it, but yeah. I'm going to go ahead and peel it because it's quick and easy.
When you have a peeler.
Yes, if you didn't, it would take the whole show.
Yeah, that's great.
Yes. Now, have you ever been in the Fantasticks or directed?
I have not.
No?
I have not.
I have not either.
Really?
I know.
It's a show that one of us have been in.
That is a rare bird.
Maybe we've been in and we just can't remember.
That very well may be.
I think there are some roles that we've probably aged out of.
Aging ingenue.
Yes.
Depends on the venue.
That's true.
Okay.
If we did at the Astrodome, we might be able to play the boy, the girl.
Okay, so here's my nice, and I don't know if you can see, those seeds are very small. If you get the peeler cucumbers, they're thicker, and mm-hmm. a lot of people just cut those out because they can make you burp. They're not very tasty. These.
Sometimes when I use those English cucumbers, I take the seeds out too.
You certainly can. Yeah.
But it's up to you. But mm-hmm. it's nice that you don't have to. It's like those little tiny seeds in watermelons. Those seedless watermelons. There are no seedless watermelons.
Kind of an optional thing.
Yeah.
There are no seedless watermelons.
Well, there's not.
That's true. Just
if
like
there were
cucumbers.
Seedless watermelons. How would you have?
We would have watermelons.
That's right. You got that for free, folks.
There you go. Biology 101.
Yes.
Red onion. So I'm going to dice up this beautiful red onion. I love a Greek salad, which is the tomatoes, the cucumbers, the red onion, some olives, and I'm just going to dice that up. So pretty. It's colorful too.
It is. Your dishes are very colorful.
They're very colorful. Well, and you know, Kevin makes fun of me when I say this because I'm like, it's a template. But quinoa, if you have a favorite vegetable or something, mm-hmm. you can put in cauliflower, you could put in asparagus, you could put in zucchini, anything you want with a nice vinaigrette makes a lovely little salad. And over here, Kevin, could you give me that thing of tomatoes?
Yes.
Tomatoes? Thank you.
I'll just hand you everything that's over here because I think you're going to need that.
I will need it. Here come my tomatoes. Are you in a moment that you can talk?
Okay.
I'll be right back.
All right. I've got another pot of risotto going. This one is almost finished. So you can see the consistency of the rice in there. This, you can see how this is smaller. Hasn't soaked up all the juice yet. This has juice, chicken stock. Sorry for those of your sticklers for terms. So I'm gonna finish this up real quick, and then we're going to put our finishing touches on this risotto that I've had going for a while.
Oh, it looks good. Okay, I have my cucumbers. I have my onion, I have my tomatoes. Olives, Greek salad, olives. These are kalamatas, I love. Some people feel very strongly about olives, and I do. I love them. Our camera person might be shaking her head, but she does not love them. And she's wrong. That's okay.
But the nice thing about kalamata is even when you cut them in half, they're big enough that if people don't like them and you don't know that when you're making it, mm-hmm. they can pull them out.
They can pull them out.
That's not hard to do.
But there's a nice saltiness that comes with these kalamatas. So this is going in.
Yeah. I'm not a big black olive fan, but I do love those.
I love black would be my least favorite. Olive, I like kalamatas a lot. I like the green ones, but I like the black olives too. If I'm gonna rank them. Okay, doesn't that look pretty? Now we're gonna make the vinaigrette for the Greek salad. Oh yeah, look there. We're gonna stir it up here in a minute, and it's probably too full. But I'll deal with that when I have to.
It's her spiritual gift. Fill it to the brim.
Okay, again, here's half a cup of olive oil. I'm putting in 3 tablespoons of red wine vinegar. There we go. Kevin's favorite, garlic.
Yes, Jeter's garlic.
Jeter's garlic. There we go.
I had to chop mine before we started filming today.
How's your arm?
It's the shoulder.
Ooh, so strong. Okay. So chopping all that garlic.
It is.
A little bit of oregano. Ooh. About a half a teaspoon. I'm just going to eyeball that. A little bit of Dijon mustard.
Oh, I love Dijon mustard.
I love mustard too. Mm. Oh, ooh, just popped right up. Okay,
I've
here
almost
we go.
Stopped using regular yellow mustard because it tastes so, even on sandwiches, it just, that spiciness of it.
No, yeah. No. Sorry, Frenches. It's just, this is better. This is better.
It's a miracle,
okay.
Too, you know.
It is a miracle.
It's a miracle.
Guess what's coming? Oh. Salt and pepper.
Oh my gosh, that's great.
Here we go. Just gonna whisk this up. Now, this doesn't really have a sweetener because this is not a sweet salad. With the sweet potatoes, hence the name, had that little sweetener in there. This gets that nice flavor from the oregano, from the vinegar. It looks good.
It looks so good.
Nice. You're dressing now? Oh, that smells great.
I'm about to dress. I need a new spoon.
As you dress, can I go ahead and finish off my risotto finally?
Oh, please do. Please do. Wash your arm. Wash your arm.
This is our tray out. This one has been going for about 40 minutes. Yes, I said 40 minutes of stirring and having, but it's worth it. So this is just about done. You can see there's still a little creamy consistency. At this point, if you'd like, you can put in some heavy cream. Some people like to do that. I don't think this needs it because we're gonna put in a cup of Parmesan cheese.
Parmesan.
Yeah, it's gonna go right in there. We're gonna let that melt. You see the beautiful color that it adds to the dish.
So what could you add if you wanted to get a little color in there?
You could add some mushrooms, but I mean it'd be brown.
Mm-hmm. Mushrooms would be great because it's that rice has an earthiness to it anyway, and I think mushrooms go really well with risottos.
If you love risotto but you don't want to stir for an hour, Trader Joe's has frozen risotto.
Oh my gosh.
It's a mushroom risotto. 5 minutes, it's fantastic.
We're still looking for a sponsor.
Yes.
TJ.
Yeah.
Call us.
Any of you. So look, you can't even tell there's Parmesan in it.
It's all melted.
I'm gonna add some color in just a second. So
you could put peas in there.
Peas
would be nice. Yeah.
And if you put peas and use frozen peas or fresh peas, either one of those would work. Don't use canned peas.
No, they're mushy. Don't do it. Just avoid canned peas. You heard it here first, folks.
A little salt.
Look at that beautiful. That's not how you say it.
I couldn't because you were speaking.
Salt and pepper. Look at that pretty Greek salad. Now, I've got some feta cheese, but what I suggest is you add the cheese as you're serving it on the side.
That's a good
because,
idea.
You know, if you're gonna refrigerate it for a while, it's gonna get kind of mushy, and you want that nice separation of your cheese. So just keep it on the side, but have it handy.
So good.
All right.
Easy, and you know, this is gonna stay in your fridge probably 4 to 5 days. You can take it for lunch, pull it out, you know, to add to a dinner. It's a very utilitarian meal for everybody. Oh, look at that. And I'm going to give us... Is there anything else we need to say about the Fantasticks?
We have to sing the song that really is the theme for this episode. Soon it's gonna grain. Isn't that it?
That's right. I can...
Eat it.
That's good.
For those
that is a beautiful song, by the way.
So I'm going to put some parsley on the top of this. Look at that. That's all the color it needed.
Yeah. Okay, I'm going to put our two salads on here.
Okay. We got a meal.
And we're going to try this
out. How about I get some
forks? Look at that. I got some right here.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, look at that.
I'm very excited. Let's do salad, risotto salad.
Salad, risotto salad. Okay, I'm going to start with the sweet potato. Okay.
How do we end up with an episode with no dessert?
Oh, it tastes like a dessert.
I like that a lot.
A little bit of sweetness.
Just a little bit.
So good. Okay.
All right, so risotto time.
Risotto.
Good.
Creamy. You don't need to add cream.
That's what I say.
I think that's gilding the lily, as they say. Mm-hmm. You don't need it. It's creamy
the cheese,
because of the rice. Yeah, and the cheese does make it creamy, but even without the cheese, you don't need it. Okay, let's go to Greece.
Let's go to Greece. I would love to go to Greece.
I would love to go to Greece. I gotta get tomato and an olive.
My finger, Brenna. Yeah.
I love Greek salads.
Mm-hmm. I like that a lot too.
Mm-hmm. All winners.
All from grains.
Mm-hmm. Our friend, the grain.
I love it.
Well, thank you for joining us on our trip around the grain world.
Oh, that's right.
And try some of these at home. Put something in the comments if there's a show or a food you'd like to see us feature. And we will see you next time on Sing for Your Supper. Bye.